to Operation Spring Tide as it's been called. We'll see if we can travel around the whole of the United Kingdom and those with the Queen's funeral next Monday. So certainly things to witness unfolding. We're staying on these images of the Queen's final journey.
Very good, Shelby. Okay, one more.
With Aberdeen on the first site of the cortege. There's a special spot for people to do the cortege as it passes Duffy Park in Aberdeen. Those who are in Aberdeen or overnight are looking at
it. Wow, the love.
Take us through it when we get a little closer view. That's all the pictures. We're also joined now by our correspondent Emma Murphy, who's at the Palace of Parliament House in Edinburgh. And the cortege is on a 6-hour journey to Wales, where you are, Emma. We've been talking about the Queen's love for Scotland. This is clearly an event for the whole nation to witness. Will be happening at Holyrood Palace, and just tell us a little bit about the Queen's incredibly close connection to that place.
Well, you know, the question the Queen is making a journey that she would have done through some of the most beautiful landscapes that she treasured, through towns that she knew well, and through towns which really treasured her. And that is what has struck me while watching the images of the cortege, making it so all the way down here to Edinburgh. The number of people who have been out on the sides of the roads, who have been there waiting, watching, holding their moment in this moment of history, wanting an opportunity to pay their respects. There's the late monarch that passes to their communities that often held her very dear, because although we might associate the Queen with the royal family, Scotland really have a special affinity with the late Queen. I've been speaking to people over the last couple of days, and there was a feeling very much that whilst the rest of the world saw her.